Hey everyone, this is Chelsea. I'm a doctor of physical therapy with Renew Physical Therapy, and today's video is about what to expect at your first visit with a pelvic floor physical therapist. So, if you've recently been referred to pelvic floor physical therapy, or you're just interested and you may potentially want to check out pelvic PT, this video is for you. So, keep watching to find out more about what happens at your first visit. The first thing that your pelvic therapist will do is take a detailed history. So this will include your medical history, any issues like blood pressure or diabetes, anything that may be relevant to your health. Next, we'll ask you about any surgical history. So that could be an orthopedic surgery, whether you've had back surgery, knee surgery, anything like that, or a gynecologic surgery like a hysterectomy, or something that cut through your abdomen that could have left some scar tissue. We'll also talk about childbirth history. If you've had any kids, did you have vaginal births or C-sections? And just pregnancy history in general. So any medical history that you want to share with us, we will gladly listen. It can be important to know the full picture so we can give you the best care possible. So after we get a detailed history, the next thing we will do is a physical exam. So your physical therapist will look at you top down, standing, seated, just to look at your posture, how you're moving, how your back moves, your hips. We'll also assess for any tender points along your abdomen or your hips. And we also like to look at strength, so core strength, hip strength, lower leg strength. We might watch you do some movements like squatting, standing on one leg. And if you have any specific movement or exercise or whatever that triggers the symptoms that you're having, for instance, like every time you do a jumping jack, you leak urine. That might be something that we watch too. So, how do your jumping jacks? Are your knees diving in? Are you weaker on one side versus the other? So we can really get a better picture of like exactly how you're moving so we can help treat you in a specific way. And that could be for running. We can assess your running, walking, really any movement. That's what we are experts in, is watching you move and seeing how we can fine-tune things to help you move better. After your full physical external exam, you also have the option to do an internal pelvic floor muscle exam. So the pelvic floor is basically this group of muscles right here, and they lie at the bottom of your pelvis and they help support you. So they hold up all the organs. They're kind of like the base of your core, if you want to think about it that way. So they have to contract to help keep everything in, and then of course they relax whenever it's time to urinate or defecate or kind of do those bodily functions. So an internal pelvic floor muscle exam will give your therapist a better picture about how these muscles are functioning. We can also look at scar tissue, at strength, endurance, coordination. These are all things that will help us figure out what is going on with that pelvic floor so we can treat it and help you get better. Next, we'll talk about a treatment plan. So we will explain the findings from your exam, and then we will discuss specific items that can help it get better. So, for instance, if you had a lot of weakness in your pelvic floor, we will be able to help you do some exercises to strengthen that area to help with, whatever issue that you're having. We'll also talk about your goals again. So, how the treatments that we do can help align with what you can do at home, what you can do on your own, and then what you can do in the clinic too. So I won't want to give you, 20 exercises if you've got a baby and a toddler and you're not going to have time to do that. So really making sure that we can focus your home exercise program and kind of work it into your normal day to make you the most likely as possible to follow through with it. Make it easy for you. In the clinic, we can work more specifically on strengthening activities, manual therapies, whatever we need to do to help you feel better. So we just want to make sure that whatever treatment that we're doing is aligned with your goals and helps you get back to doing what you want to do. That's the goal. That's why you're here in the first place, is because you want to feel better and move better. And so physical therapy can help you do that. So if you have been referred for a pelvic floor condition, or you're interested in seeking physical therapy, I would definitely encourage you to reach out to a local physical therapist. Know that a lot of these conditions are very common. Sometimes people don't like to talk about them, but they are very common, and know that there is help. If you're willing to try it out, there's definitely help for you, and hope that you consider reaching out to a pelvic floor physical therapist. Thanks. I hope this video gave you some things to think about consulting with a pelvic floor therapist, and I hope you found it educational. If you'd like to see more videos about pelvic floor physical therapy, exercises for your pelvic floor, and other tips, please subscribe to this channel where we talk about all things pelvic floor physical therapy related.